What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about configuring device security using a group policy. So let's get right into it. All right, so you're probably saying to yourself, what do you mean, Bernardo, about configuring device security using a group policy? Well, hopefully you guys understand what a group policy is, but device security is this. Bam. Within the Windows security section with, you know, I think Windows 10 and Windows 11, the device security will always have that exclamation point. That was driving me nuts. And I wanted to figure out a way to disable it. Not disable it, but configure it in a way that it would disappear and give me that green check mark. And this is how I did it. So I went into one of my workstations, and it is PC02. I clicked on Start. I scrolled down until I located the Windows Administrative Tools folder. I clicked on it to open it up. And I scrolled down again until I located the Group Policy Management app. So click on the app to launch it. There it goes. Now, I typically like to go into the Group Policy Objects folder, and I am going to right-click on that folder and then select New, and I'm going to give it a name. Pretty self-explanatory. We're going to click OK. You're going to select your new GPO. We're going to right-click on it, and we're going to select Edit. Now, we need to tackle the computer configuration node. We're going to double click on policies. We are going to double click on administrative templates. And within here, we need to get into the systems folder. Now within the system folder, we need to locate the device guard folder. There it goes. Now on the right-hand side, you're going to see two options. And the option that we are going to configure would be the following. Turn on virtualization-based security. We're going to double click on it. And we're going to enable it. Now, by default, this is what you get. Now, I can't really tell you what to do within your environment. This is what I did within my environment to get rid of that crazy exclamation point, that warning, and get green check marks. So you have to play around with the settings. But for me, this is what I did. Bam. For the platform security level, I switched it to secure boot. For the virtualization-based protection, I switched it to enable with UEFI lock. For the credential guard configuration, I configured again with UEFI lock. And the last one was secure launch configuration, I enable it. That's all I did. I clicked on apply, I clicked on OK, and I closed the new GPO. Now it is time for us to apply it to an organizational unit. Now I'm going to apply it to this particular OU, TESS, and within TESS, we have PC01. PC01 was the machine that I showed you guys, that screenshot that I showed you guys that had the exclamation point. PC01 is the one with the crazy exclamation point, which I was trying to get rid of via a GPO. So this is the one, this is my guinea pig. So let's head over to the group policy management. Select the test OU. We're going to right click on it and we're going to select link an existing GPO. We're going to select our new GPO and we're going to click OK. We're going to select our organizational unit and we're going to right click on it and we're going to select group policy update. We're going to click yes here and it's going to update. Now, this right here, you don't have to do it because this group policy is for the computers. Computers normally get the refresh when it reboots. This is great when you're doing users. So I took the extra step. I did reboot the machine and I went into my Proxmox. This is PC01. I rebooted it. Once it rebooted, I logged into the machine. Once I logged into the machine, I loaded up the Windows security console. And right there, device security, green check mark. Beautiful. When you click on it, you get everything green checkmark. Everything was configured using the group policy. And if you click on core isolation details, you're going to see that it is managed by the administrator, which is me via the group policy. Awesome. So that's working and that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.